There are times when you may want to host your remote Git repository within your network. The reasons for this are varied. Perhaps you'll be storing sensitive data which you don't want to trust to a cloud provider. Or maybe you want the speed advantage of having your Git server on your local network. I recommend setting up your own private Git repository. This way you don't have to worry about what is being stored in your repository, as your repository is private. Nor do you have to worry about storage, as local storage is large and cheap. To do this properly, we'd need two hosts. I will set this up on my RHost 2 VM and have the RHost 1 client contacted through the network. However, this will also work just fine on one host. It's just not how we'd build it in a real environment. To run it on one host, we'll just have the client host contact itself over the network. To create a remote Git repository easily, we'll be using SSH keys, which means you'll probably want the Git repository on an operating system that has an SSH server, such as Linux, Unix, or macOS, although it can also work on Windows using Win32 OpenSSH. Go to the host where the remote repository will reside. For me, this is RHost 2. If you plan on doing this exercise on one host, just follow along as these instructions will work for that scenario as well. Let's start by creating a Git user. Type in sudo space user add space git and hit enter. Type in your password if prompted. Now let's give the Git user a password. Type in sudo space passwd space git and hit enter. Now give the Git user a password. Now make a directory for the Git repository. We'll call it gitproject2.git and place it in /srv/git. Where you put this is not that important, as long as the Git user has access to it. Type in sudo space mkdir space -p space /srv/git/gitproject2.git. Make sure you use the -p option so it creates the parent directories. Notice that I've used the .git naming convention for this directory. This is to tell me that this is a remote repository being served out to other hosts. We will not cd into this directory and do commits. Now change into the gitproject2.git directory by typing in cd /srv/git/gitproject2.git and hit enter. Now we'll initialize a bare Git repository. Type in sudo space git space init space --bare and hit enter. That's the basic Git server setup. Now let's set permissions. CD up two levels by typing in CD space /srv and hit enter. And we'll change the ownership of the Git directory to the Git user and the Git group. Type in sudo space chown space -R space git.git/git and hit enter. All files should now be owned by the Git user and the Git group. Let's verify. Type in ls space -L R space git and hit enter. And we can see that they are. Before we move to the client, we need to know the IP address of this host. Type in clear, and then type in ifconfig, and hit enter. My IP address is 192.168.1.125. Even if you're using one host for this exercise, you will still need to note the IP address, as you will still be using it. Now let's move over to the client host. In my case, this is RHost 1. Again, if you're doing this on one host, that's fine. We'll just have our client contact our server, which happens to be the same host with the same IP address. Let's create a new local project called gitproject2. Type in mkdir space -p space /remote-repos/gitproject2 and hit enter. Notice that I didn't include the .git portion of the name. This tells me this is a Git project directory that I'll cd into and make commits. The naming convention is actually up to you. Now change into it. Type in cd space /remote-repos/gitproject2 and hit enter. And we'll initialize the repository by typing git space init. Now let's copy a few files to it. Type in cp space /etc/passwd /etc/hosts /etc/resolve.conf /. Make sure you add the dot at the end. This says to copy these files to the current directory, which is the gitproject2 directory. If you're using an OS without these files, choose some other files to copy. Now hit enter. Now stage the files for a commit. Type in git space add space dot. The dot matches all files in the directory. Go ahead and hit enter. Now we'll commit them with git space commit space -m space double quote initial space commit double quote. And hit enter. Now let's add our Git server as a remote. For me, this would be git space remote space add space origin space git at, and then my IP address of my RH host 2 VM, 192.168.1.125. You want to use your IP address here, /srv/git/git project2.git. Now press enter. Now verify with git space remote space dash v and hit enter. We can see that we have one remote host for fetching and pushing to. Now let's push our files to the remote. Type in git space push space origin space master and hit enter. Say yes to accept the fingerprint. And now type in the git user's password and hit enter. If successful, you'll see it in the message on the screen. Now other hosts can clone this repository by typing in git clone followed by the same URL. Again, adjust the IP address to match your host. Now what we want to do is use SSH keys for authentication. Once this is done, you can commit and push to the remote repository without being bothered with typing in a password. You will want to be on your Git client. I'm logged into my RHost 1 VM. To use SSH keys for authentication, we need to create our key pairs on our client and then copy the public key to the Git server. On your client, type in ssh-keygen space dash t space rsa space dash b space 4096 space dash capital C space double quote, and then your email address. Be sure to use your email address here. Also, if you plan on using these keys for GitHub, make sure the email addresses match. Now hit enter. It will ask us the name of the file to save the keys as. You can take the default here. For the passphrase, leave it blank and hit enter twice. We can view the key pair by listing the .ssh directory. Type in ls space tilde slash .ssh and hit enter. We can see that we have an ID underscore RSA key, that's our private key, and an ID underscore RSA.pub, which is our public key. Now using the SSH copy ID command, we can copy the public key to the Git server. Type in clear, type in ssh-copy-id space git at and your Git server IP address. In my case, it's 192.168.1.125. You want to make sure you use your IP address here and hit enter. It will prompt you for the Git password on the Git server. Type that in and hit enter. If successful, it'll say number of keys added, 1. It'll also say to test it, type in SSH space git at and your IP address, which you see on the screen. Let's go ahead and do that. Type in SSH space git at, in my case, it's 192.168.1.125, and hit enter. And if it's successful, you can log in without a password, which I did. Once you've done this, type in exit. Note, you can do this manually and append this public key to the .ssh/authorizedkeys file on the remote host, but the SSH copy ID command takes care of it for us, as well as setting permissions. If your operating system has the SSH copy ID command, save yourself some trouble and use it. You may not want people logging in interactively as the Git user with SSH, so you may want to change the shell for the Git user to git-shell. I won't go into that here, but it's a good idea. Check the git-shell man page for more information. I've mentioned that you can also use these keys for the GitHub repository too. First, let's copy the SSH key into our clipboard. Type in clear, and then type in cat space tilde slash .ssh slash id underscore rsa dot pub. Make sure you have the .pub file as it's the public key. And then highlight it and copy it into your clipboard. Now bring up a web browser and log into your GitHub account. Click on the photo on the top right, and then click on Settings. In the left-hand pane, click on SSH and GPG keys, and then click on New SSH key. Give it a title, I'm going to call mine RHost 1, and then paste the key into the next box. And then lastly, click on Add SSH key. Now the key is on GitHub. The last thing we need to do is change our remotes from HTTPS to the Git protocol. Click on the GitHub logo and then click on your repository. And then click on Clone or Download and click on Use SSH. You'll want to copy that URL into your clipboard. Now go back to your terminal, type in clear, and then change into your Git Project 1 directory. Type in cd space Git project 1 and hit enter. And let's look at the remotes. Type in git space remote space dash v and hit enter. You'll notice that both remotes use the HTTPS protocol. We'll want to change this to git. Type in git space remote space set dash URL space origin space and then paste the URL you copied from GitHub and hit enter. And we can verify with git space remote space dash v and hit enter. You could also test it by committing a change and trying to push it.